that, we are going to continue working with the present perfect and the past simple, the comparison, okay? So today we are going to have on a speaking activity, and also we are going to practice listening, okay? For the exam. So we're going to start with that practice of speaking. I'm going to show you here my screen. Just give me a second. So we are going to do a game. Okay. Okay, here we have it. Can you see my screen now?
Yes, teacher. Yes, teacher.
Okay, perfect. So here we have some images and we have some expressions. So I'm going to show you here. For example, number one, we have here someone playing hockey, right? And we have this expression, never. So what we are going to do, entonces, ¿qué vamos a hacer, chicos, para esta actividad de speaking? Nosotros vamos a jugar, ¿cierto? Vamos a hacer un juego matemático. Ustedes saben que me gustan aquí las matemáticas. Yo los pongo a sumar o a restar y el que adivine, no sé qué pasa en la calle, tiene una gritería horrible. Bueno, el que adivine va a tener el privilegio, ¿cierto? De escoger a un compañero y le va a decir qué imagen, con qué frase debe hacer una pregunta o debe hacer una oración o en negación, como la persona lo quiera hacer, ¿sí? Puede ser pregunta, negación o afirmación. Entonces, ¿qué es lo que vamos a tener en cuenta? Entonces, de acuerdo a la expresión que nos toque, nosotros vamos a saber en qué tiempo debemos hacerlo, ¿ok? Por ejemplo, si nos toca never, ¿en qué tiempo deberíamos hacerlo?
Present perfect.
Ajá, present perfect. Entonces, si nos toca never, utilizamos el presente perfecto. Si nos toca, por ejemplo, last week.
Pasado simple.
Ajá, pasado simple. Igual con el resto. Entonces, already, presente perfecto. Just, presente perfecto. Last winter, pasado simple. Today, present perfect. Recently, present perfect. An hour ago, last, ¿cierto? Es past simple, sorry. Never again, last night, yesterday, this week, etc., etc., etc. Entonces vamos a analizar, ¿cierto? ¿Qué expresión nos toca? Y de acuerdo a ese análisis, pues hacemos ya sea una afirmación, una negación, ¿cierto? O una pregunta, ¿ok? Entonces vamos a comenzar con el juego. Entonces, a ver. Hello, everybody here. Carolina, Kate. Who else was here? Wasn't here, just Carolina and Kate. Hello, how are you? Ok, para Carolina y para Kate que acaban de llegar, vamos a hacer una actividad de speaking. Y vamos a hacer nuestro juego matemático de suma y resta en inglés, ¿ok? Entonces, quien me diga la respuesta en inglés va a ganar la oportunidad de darle a un compañero una imagen con una frase. Esta frase o expresión va a evocar ya sea al presente perfecto o al pasado simple. Entonces, esta persona que le toque esa imagen con esa frase, pues debe hacer ya sea una oración afirmativa, negativa o interrogativa, dependiendo de lo que, de la expresión, ¿ok? Si dice never, pues ya sabemos que es negativa, pero no necesita utilizar la negación, ¿cierto? Ya está ahí en el never. Si quiere hacer una pregunta, lo puede hacer, pero debe utilizar esa expresión y una afirmación también. Y obviamente la imagen, lo que usted, la oración que vaya a realizar tiene que ver con la imagen y la expresión que está ahí, ¿ok? So, let's start. I'm going to start with the numbers. So, I'm going to remember you guys. When I say plus, cuando yo diga plus es más, and if I say minus es menos. Okay? So we have to be very attentive, and we're going to start now. And we have 1 + 2 + 7 - 5. How much is that?
5. 5. 5.
Okay, who said 5? ¿Quién dijo 5?
Me, teacher.
Okay, so Kathy. Recuerden que las respuestas tienen que ser en inglés. Era 5.
Bueno, entonces Kate dijo 5 y yo dije 5.
Oh, no, yo dije 5.
¿Quién dijo? Yo fui la que dije 5.
Ah, yo dije 5. Ok, Kate. It's your turn.
Okay, so perfect. Both of you. Entonces, a ver. Entonces va a elegir Kate y va a elegir Yoka también a una persona. So, Kate, first. Choose an image. Escoge una imagen, Kate.
Teacher, se le entendió, no le entendí.
Okay. Cambia la red. Pensamos.
Teacher, I can hear you.
Okay, wait. Chan, hola. Chicos, ¿me escuchan? Hello.
Ver,
yes, okay, perfect. Kate, te estaba preguntando, ¿qué imagen quieres escoger para un compañero? So, which image do you want?
Yesterday.
Yesterday. This one. Yes?
Oscar Santiago.
Okay, so Oscar, welcome back, and you have your first activity. So Oscar, you have to make a sentence, a question, or a negation with that image and this phrase, yesterday, this expression.
Pero,
or finish time. Acá estamos haciendo una comparación, Oscar. Entonces, si tiene una expresión que evoque al pasado, ¿sí? Que haga referencia al pasado, vas a utilizar pasado simple. Entonces, harías una oración en pasado simple, o una pregunta en pasado simple, o una negación en pasado simple, ¿ok? Si tiene una expresión, en cambio, que se refiera al presente perfecto, pues utilizas el presente perfecto. En este caso, se refiere al pasado. Entonces, simplemente tendrías que hacer una oración en pasado simple, utilizando yesterday,
por ejemplo,
y la imagen.
I went to Cartagena yesterday.
Sí, pero entonces ya no tendría que ver con la imagen, porque mira que ellos están ahí como cantando.
I went to, pero sí, digamos más o menos, sí, I went to Cartagena yesterday to some.
Tú puedes decir, por ejemplo, I went to a pub yesterday in Cartagena. Entonces fui a un bar ayer en Cartagena. Y en el bar podemos asociar cantaste, era un karaoke. O I went to a karaoke in Cartagena yesterday. Okay.
I went to karaoke Cartagena yesterday.
Perfect. Very good. So now, Yoka, choose your image. So what image do you want? From here.
Four hours ago.
This one.
Jessica.
For Jessica, okay, so Jessica, you have this image and this phrase, 4 hours ago. So what is your
picture? I didn't dance 4 hours ago.
Perfect, I didn't dance 4 hours ago. Very good. So now, guys, be ready. Here we go again. So we got 2 plus 2 minus 3 minus 1. How much is that?
2? 0.
Very good. Very good. Who said 0?
Me, teacher.
Perfect. Joka. So go ahead, Joka. Choose your image.
Okay. Since Monday.
Since Monday. This one. To whom?
For Carolina.
Carolina. So, Caro, you have this image, a boy reading a book, and this expression, since Monday. So, what is your sentence?
No podía ver la pantalla. ¿Cuál me tocó?
Since Monday. This one. ¿Lo ves?
No.
Yes. Okay, wait. El niño pelirrojo al lado derecho, debajo de last year, dice since Monday.
Present perfect.
Yes, perfect. ¿Y cuál sería tu oración con esa imagen y esa expresión?
I have read since Monday.
Okay, I have read since Monday. Bueno, puede decir que he leído desde el lunes. I have read since Monday. Okay, it could be better if you say what, right? I have read a book or an interesting book since Monday. Perfect, very good. So now, guys, let's be attentive again. So now we have minus 4 plus 3.
Minus 1.
Okay. Again, who said minus 1?
¿Qué dijo, profe?
¿Quién dijo menos uno? Minus one.
Yo.
Okay, no, aquí, so go ahead. Choose your image. Which one do you want?
Already.
Already. This one. To whom or for whom?
For Valentina.
Okay, for Rocio. So, Rocio, you have to make a sentence with this image and this expression. It
is present perfect.
Yes.
Entonces, they have danced already.
Remember that already goes after half. So they have already danced.
Ah, they have already had.
They have already danced. Perfect. Very good. They have already danced. So now, guys, be attentive. So now we have 7 plus 4 plus 6. How much is that?
16.
12. Okay, 17. What's 17? Miguel, was it you?
I said 12.
It's not 12, because I said 7 plus 4 plus 6. So it was 17. ¿Quién dijo 17? 17.
Yo.
Okay, Oscar, so go ahead. Oscar, last week or weekend. Where is weekend? This one or this one?
para Miguel Ángel.
Okay, I think it's this one. Last winter or week?
Last winter.
Okay, San Miguel, last winter. Let's do a sentence. Miguel, are you there?
Yes.
Okay. That is a snowman. Nombre de nieve. O un muñeco de nieve. Snowman. ¿Cómo dices qué?
¿Cómo se llama?
Snowman. Muñeco de nieve. Snowman.
The children. The children.
Children. Children.
Began. The snowman last winter.
Okay. Pero ese began, como comenzaron o hicieron mejor.
No, es hicieron.
Entonces sería made, okay?
Okay.
So the children made a snowman last winter. Perfect. Very good. So now, guys, let's be attentive. Now we have 20 plus 20 plus 20 minus 40. How much is that?
20.
20.
Yes, it is 20. Perfect. So, Joka and Kate, let's choose some images. Joka, go ahead. Which one do you want?
Okay. Last night.
Last night. This one. To whom?
For Norquis.
For Norquis. Okay. So Norquis. Let's do that one. It says last night and he's sleeping.
Sería. did he sleep good last night? Él durmió bien anoche, no sé.
Did he sleep good last night? Perfect. Very good. That is a good question. So now, Kate. To whom? Let's choose an image. Which one do you want?
Never.
This one. To whom?
For Alexander.
Okay. So, Sus lady, you have never. What sentence could you make?
He has never
played, right? Jugar, maybe.
He has never played hockey.
Very good, very good. Perfect. So now, guys, let's be attentive. 1 + 1 + 2 + 1. How much is that?
5.
Yes. So Jessica.
An hour ago.
And now where to go? This one.
For Alexander.
For Sus Lady again. That's Sus Lady. So Sus Lady.
Okay.
Now you have. And now where to go?
They sun. Mm-hmm. An hour ago.
Perfect. No. They sang an hour ago. Perfect. Ellos cantaron hace una hora. Very good. Perfect. For now, let's be attentive, guys. So I'm going to give a free shot to each one of you. So les voy a dar un turno libre a cada uno. So, sus lady, choose an image and choose a classmate. Which one do you want?
Just.
Okay, just. This one. To whom or for whom?
Catherine.
Okay, perfect. Okay. Catherine. So you have here, just.
Teacher, the juice.
It's for what? Present perfect, okay?
¿Va en algún sitio específico en la oración?
Yes. It goes after half. Okay. Después de half.
Thank you. Entonces, I have just
play
the game.
Perfect.
I have just
So now, Andres, choose an image and choose a classmate.
¿Cuál, profe?
Escoge una imagen, la que tú quieras, y luego escoges a un compañero para que haga una oración con ella.
La del videojuego.
Esta la acabaron, ok, no importa.
Bueno, la del trofeo.
Okay, this one, never.
No.
¿Para quién?
Para Norki.
Okay, Norki. So, Norki, you have this one.
I have never win one. ¿Cómo sería?
One.
A cup.
Very good. Or a trophy. Perfect. Okay. I have never won a trophy. Very good. So now, Carolina, choose an image and choose a classmate.
Ready. Alexander.
Okay, already, Sus Lady, you have this one.
Okay.
He's like watching his face. Está lavándose como la cara. Okay?
Peter. Alex, already.
Yes.
Cleans the face.
Perfect. Very good. So Alex has already cleaned his face. Perfect. Very good. So now, Kate, choose an image and choose a classmate.
Y teacher, uno que estaba arriba.
Which one?
Recently.
Okay, recently. Recientemente.
Recently.
To whom?
Daniela.
Okay, perfect. So, Dani. Hello, Dani.
Hello, teacher.
How are you?
Fine, and you?
I'm great. So here you have your image. This one is your image and your phrase recently. Your expression.
I have recently
Water.
Water the flowers.
Perfect. Recently, como es un adverbio, va, puedes colocarlo al final, ¿ok? Entonces puedes decir, I have watered the flowers recently, ¿ok?
Ok, teacher.
Perfect. So now, Dani, choose an image and choose a classmate.
Today.
Today. Ok, to whom?
Norquis.
Norquis, okay. So, Norquis, you have this one today.
Today, teacher.
Yeah.
Okay. Sería, has Maria swimming today? No sé.
Swim, tienes que colocarlo en pasado participio. Okay. Swim es. Creo que ese es de los que viene con los tres, creo que es swam, swim. Espérate, yo rectifico por qué. No estoy muy segura.
Si es pasado participio es swim.
Swim, ¿cierto?
Yes.
Ok, entonces sí, tienes que colocar el verbo en swim. Entonces dilo de nuevo, ¿cómo sería?
Sería has Maria swim. Uh-huh.
Uh-huh. Perfect. Very good. Has Maria swum today? Very good. So now, let's continue here with Jessica. So Jessica, choose an image and a classmate.
Last year, teacher.
Last year, this one. For to whom? Daniela.
Yes, Daniela, excuse me.
Okay. For Daniela, Dani, last year.
I read the math last year.
Perfect. I read the math last year. Very good. So now, Miguel, choose an image and a classmate. Here is Angela. You can ask her. Hello, Angela.
Hello, teacher. Estoy perdida, pero estoy poniendo cuidado.
Okay, so Miguel, go ahead. Choose an image and a classmate. Miguel?
For ages.
For ages. This one.
Yes.
And a classmate. To whom? Yoka.
Yoka.
Okay. What a nice. So, Yoka, you have for ages. And this
coño,
image.
Por fin, se olvidaron de mí hoy.
Sí, no la habían llamado, pero nadie. No, la tuve por un tendido. Yo cuando la habían llamado.
¿Cuál es?
This one, for ages.
For ages. I have ya tiene, creo que ya tiene un psicólogo.
Puede ser, o puede ser que están conversando.
Okay. I have a friend for ages.
Okay. Ahí estás utilizando no. Ahí estás utilizando have como pertenencia. Yo tengo una amiga por años. Pero no, yo he tenido. Entonces sería I have had
a friend for ages.
Perfect. Very good. So now, Oscar, choose an image. And a classmate.
Last one.
Perfect. To whom? Para quién?
Para Andrés.
Okay, Andrés.
Hola.
Hello, here you have last month. Tienes que hacer una oración en pasado simple utilizando la expresión last month.
We were last month playing.
Al revés, we were playing last month.
Last month in park.
Okay, that's perfect. So we were playing in the park last month. Very good. So now, Rocío, choose a question, choose an image, and choose a partner, a classmate. From here.
Teacher. Yes. For abajo, teacher.
Okay.
4 hours ago.
Okay. To whom? Para quién?
Angela.
Para Angela. Okay. So, Angela, here we have it. Angela, estamos haciendo oraciones de acuerdo a las expresiones que nos toquen. Entonces, si la expresión se refiere al pasado, pues utilizamos pasado simple. Si la expresión se refiere al presente perfecto, presente perfecto. ¿Ok?
Ah, ok, teacher. I ate hamburger for 4 hours ago.
Ok, en este caso tenemos que hacer que también combine con la imagen. Entonces ellos aquí están bailando.
Ah, okay, teacher. Entonces, they danced four hours ago.
Perfect. They danced 4 hours ago. Very good. And now, the last one, Yoka, choose an image and a classmate. Yoka?
Yes, teacher.
Okay, can you choose an image and a classmate?
Yes, sorry. This week.
This week, to whom?
For whom is the teacher?
Okay. Everybody have done it. You can choose Miguel. Miguel hasn't talked a Miguel. Lot. Okay, perfect. So Miguel, this week.
Okay, teacher. He's played football this week.
Okay, he
played football.
Played. En pasado.
Ajá.
¿Por qué? Está en pasado ese this week. O está hablando de esta semana.
Está hablando de esta semana, perdón.
Ajá, so.
He has.
Ajá.
He has played this week.
Perfect. He has played soccer or football this week. Perfect. Very good. So now, guys, if you don't have any doubt, we're going to continue with our listening exercise. Okay? So do you have any doubt here? Nope. Yes?
Not teacher.
Okay, perfect. So let's continue here with our listening exercise for today. Okay, here we have it. I'm going to show you my screen. Okay, it's here. Can you see my screen now, guys?
Yes,
teacher.
Okay, perfect. So this listening is about people talking about changing their plans. Les vamos a escuchar a dos personas que van a cambiar sus planes. Tenían algo planeado, pero ya no lo van a hacer. So first, we're going to do our preparation task. So here we have it. What we're going to do here? We are going to put the words in the correct groups. Entonces, ¿qué vamos a hacer? Vamos a categorizar. ¿Ok? Entonces, vamos a colocar estas palabras en el grupo correcto. Es decir, sea entertainment events, eventos de entretenimiento, or places for entertainment. Entonces, o lugares para entretenimiento. ¿Ok? So, number one, we have here. A musician is what? What is that?
Place.
Oh. But here we have, sorry, we have people too. People and entertainment. Entonces, personas y entretenimiento. So, where it goes, a musician?
Entertainment event.
Entertainment.
People and entertainment.
Okay. People, okay, perfect. What about a concert?
People are entertainment events.
Okay. Yeah. A band, la banda.
People.
A theater, un teatro.
Place for entertainment.
Okay, a show.
Entertainment.
Event or what?
Event.
Okay, events. An opera house.
Place.
A group.
People.
Okay, people. A cinema.
Place.
Okay, places. A play. Do you know what is a play?
Tocar.
A play tocar. Es una... No, en este caso no es el verbo tocar. Ahí está como sustantivo. Y cuando decimos a play, estamos hablando de una obra, obra de teatro. ¿Ok? A play.
People.
Event or people?
Event.
People.
Oh my God.
People.
We are here divided. So I'm going to put it in people. Lo voy a poner en gente. Pero ya saben, los que están diciendo que es un evento. Si sale malo y era un evento, pues ustedes estaban bien. ¿Ok? Ok.
¿Pero qué, Tiche? No es el. ¿Cómo es?
A play es una obra de teatro.
De teatro, claro.
Sí, yo creo que es más bien la de arriba, teacher, entertainer.
Evento, es un evento. Entonces, cambiémoslo a evento. ¿Dónde está? Aquí. Now, a valet.
Event.
Okay, event. What about a gallery?
In a place.
Place. And what about an artist?
People.
Okay. So now let's check. Here we have Perfect. You did it great. Very good job, guys. So now we're going to continue here, guys, with the task number one. So here we have, and these are some true, well, this is not true or false, but we have to choose the person who talks about the things that we have there. Entonces aquí nosotros tenemos, no son preguntas, sino que son oraciones que una de estas dos personas dijeron, ya sea Francesco o Sachi. Entonces nosotros tenemos que escoger quién fue el que dijo la oración que está aquí. So here we have, runs across the street. Who? We don't know yet. Then we have, is going to buy tickets for the play. Esta es la obra de teatro. Entonces, ¿quién va a comprar los tiquetes para la obra de teatro? Vamos a ver si es Francesco o vamos a ver si es Sachi. Then we have, can't go to the play this Friday. Is a musician. Which one of those? Isn't happy about the situation. No está feliz con la situación. 2 weeks ago, esta persona, no sabemos cuál, had tickets to the cinema. Likes dance shows. Le gusta los shows de baile. Suggest that they go out to dinner. Suggest es sugerir, ¿ok? Entonces, sugiere que salgan a cenar. That is the last one. So now, guys, let's listen. Entonces, recuerden, solamente lo voy a reproducir 2 veces. Así que tomen apunte.
There are, yeah. there are eight.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Yes, 8. Okay, so are you ready? Me voy a silenciar,
yes.
Pero igual tienen algo para decirme, me avisan que yo estoy aquí escuchándolos, pero ustedes no me van a escuchar a mí porque si no se escucha doble, ¿ok? So I'm going to play the listening.
This recording is from the British Council.
Sachiko.
Francesco, is everything okay?
Yes, yes. Sorry. I saw you and I was across the street. I ran.
I see. What's up?
Do you have the tickets for the play?
No, I don't. I'm going to buy them this afternoon.
Oh, good, good. Listen, don't buy tickets for this Friday.
Oh, why not?
I can't go to the theatre on Friday. Something's come up. I have a concert this Friday.
Another concert? But you said...
I know. I'm sorry. I forgot.
Francesco.
How about next week? Are you free then? I can definitely go next Friday.
Francesco, you did this 2 weeks ago, remember? I had cinema tickets for the new Marvel movie, and you changed the plans then too. For... band practice.
I know, and I...
We also missed my favorite dance group, because your band was playing at some child's birthday party.
It was my nephew's birthday. Okay, why don't we go out for dinner before my concert? Then next Friday, we can go to the play.
Oh.
Come on, Sachi. Just this one more time.
Okay, but promise me next Friday, okay?
I promise.
This recording is from the British Council.
Sachiko.
Francesco, is everything okay?
Yes, yes. Sorry. I saw you and I was across the street. I ran.
I see. What's up?
Do you have the tickets for the play?
No, I don't. I'm going to buy them this afternoon.
Oh, good, good. Listen, don't buy tickets for this Friday.
Oh, why not?
I can't go to the theatre on Friday. Something's come up. I have a concert this Friday.
Another concert? But you said...
I know. I'm sorry. I forgot.
Francesco...
How about next week? Are you free then? I can definitely go next Friday.
Francesco, you did this 2 weeks ago, remember? I had cinema tickets for the new Marvel movie, and you changed the plans then too, for band practice.
I know, and I...
We also missed my favorite dance group, because your band was playing at some child's birthday party.
It was my nephew's birthday. Okay. Why don't we go out for dinner before my concert? Then next Friday, we can go to the play.
Oh.
Come on, Sachi. Just this one more time.
Okay. But promise me next Friday, okay?
I promise.
Okay, ready?
Yes, teacher. Yes.
The first one, it says... Who? Francesco or Sachi runs across the street?
Francesco.
Francesco. Okay. What about this one? Who, Francesco or Sachi, is going to buy tickets for the play?
Francesco.
Sachi. Francesco. Okay. No one says Francesco. Entonces, si está mal, ¿quién dijo que era Francesco? Está bien.
Yo entendí así. Yo entendí que ella todavía no los había comprado.
Okay. Then we have who, Francesco or Sachi, can't go to the play right?
Francesco.
This one, who is the musician, Francesco or Sachi?
Francesco.
Okay, aquí necesito votación. ¿Quién dice Francesco? Nombres.
Jessica.
¿Qué más?
Ángela.
¿Qué más?
Yocito.
Yoka.
Andresito. Yoka. Ok, bueno, ganó Francesco. Y el que los demás, si dicen Sachi, pues ya saben, estaban bien. This one. Isn't happy about the situation.
Sachi.
Two weeks ago, had tickets to the cinema.
Sachi.
This one likes dance shows.
Sachi.
And the last one suggests that they go out to dinner.
Francesco.
Okay, it's already there. So now let's check. Tan, 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 tan. Perfect.
Woo!
Great. You see eight out of eight. Perfect. Very good. So now we're going to do the second part. Entonces, por acá tenemos la segunda parte. ¿Qué vamos a hacer? Vamos a escucharlo una vez nada más. ¿Ok? Y luego vamos a completar estas oraciones, ¿ok? Esto ellos lo dicen. I can go to, y ustedes van a completar con la otra parte. Pero vamos a escucharlo por la última vez, ¿ok?
Ok.
This recording is from the British Council.
Sachiko.
Francesco, is everything okay?
Yes. Sorry. I saw you and I was across the street. I ran.
I see. What's up?
Do you have the tickets for the play?
No, I don't. I'm going to buy them this afternoon.
Oh, good. Listen. Don't buy tickets for this Friday.
Oh, why not?
I can't go to the theater on Friday. Something's come up. I have a concert this Friday.
Another concert? But you said...
I know. I'm sorry. I forgot.
Francesco.
How about next week? Are you free then? I can definitely go next Friday.
Francesco, you did this 2 weeks ago, remember? I had cinema tickets for the new Marvel movie, and you changed the plans then too, for band practice.
I know, and I...
We also missed my favorite dance group, because your band was playing at some child's birthday party.
It was my nephew's birthday. Okay, why don't we go out for dinner before my concert? Then next Friday, we can go to the play.
Oh.
Come on, Sachi. Just this one more time.
Okay. But promise me next Friday. Okay?
I promise.
This recording is from...
Okay, perfect. So now let's complete these sentences. The first one, it says, I can go to... Next Friday, free them, I forgot, out for dinner, go next Friday, the theater on Friday.
Friday.
The theater on Friday. How about next Friday, free them out for dinner? Because this is a question.
Next Friday.
Next Friday. Then we have, are you free then?
Go next Friday.
Go next Friday. Are you go next Friday? But this is not a question.
Are you
free then? Okay. Are you free then? I can definitely. I forgot. Or go next Friday.
Go next Friday.
Okay, go next Friday. Why don't we go out for dinner? Or I forgot.
Out for dinner.
So the last one is, I'm sorry, I forgot. So let's check. Perfect. You see? You're getting better every day. Very good, guys. You did it great. Very good job. Lo hicieron muy bien, chicos. Para que vean, el segundo día ya todas están en 100. Ah. Vamos mejorando muy rápido. Creo que voy a subir a B1. So, congratulations, guys. This is the end of our class. Okay? See you tomorrow. Bye-bye.
Bye, teacher.
Bye, teacher.
Bye.